everybody. So we are going to do some more how-to exercises. This one is how to do a crunch. I'm sure you have done crunches before, but let's just go through the basics because they are the start of, or the base of, so many good stomach core exercises. So you need to get the basics right. You need to make them as effective as possible. So a crunch. What a crunch is not is that. That's a bad sit-up. What a crunch is using the tummy muscles that you may or may not have yet to pull yourself up and then slowly release. If you do yoga or Pilates, you're probably really good at these, probably better than I am at these. So I like to start with my feet bent. Let me go a bit nearer. And my hands at my temples. What you're not doing is you're not putting your hands around to pull your head up. They're just there lightly out of the way. You could have them here. So you're coming up. I'm keeping my vision up to the ceiling. I don't want to round it because then I'm going to end up hurting my neck. I'm coming down. So I'm rolling up with my stomach, literally rolling up, and then uncurling back down. Breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in. Each time your head goes back to the floor, okay? So rolling up and rolling down until you've got some stomach muscles there. They're going to be quite hard to do, but just keep on working at them and building them up. One of the things I hear a lot is that you can end up hurting, your neck starts hurting. That's because it's a muscle like all the other muscles in our body that we've got to work. So if that's not strong, our neck is going to hurt because we've got to suddenly lift all this weight. So like any exercise, we have to build up the strength. So don't try and do 100 crunches, maybe try and do 8, have a rest, do 10, have a rest, 12, have a rest, and just keep on building them up. Obviously if you feel pain, then don't do them, something's gone wrong. So once we've got our crunch, there we go. So you might be doing 3 sets of 12, for example. There's loads of different variations you can do. So let's, for example, you could have your feet up and you could roll up and roll down a little bit harder, reaching up and reaching down, reaching up and reaching down. So you could do that one. You could do a pulse. I'm going to have my hands to the side. This one will start up here. Keep on looking at the ceiling. I'm just going to pulse that. Tummy muscles tight, okay? So tight the whole time. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, you could do a long crunch. You could come behind and then, well, it's more of a sit up, but rolling up and rolling down. It's all the same principle. It's using those tummy muscles, pulling you up and pulling you back down. So plenty of variations again that you can do with a crunch, but until you've got the basics, there's no point doing the variations. So give those a go and see how you get on. Bye.